Moin. Hi. Straße in die Liebenstraße. Invalidenpark. Thank you. Straße. Staatsoper.
Thank you.
Straße. Straße, Prenzlauer Allee.
Moin.
Holstraße, Otto-Braun-Straße. ein. Lübecke Straße, Danziger Straße. Konrad-Blenkle-Straße. Storkower Straße.
Thank you. Thank you. We've helped.
Michelangelo-Straße. Straße, Storkower Straße. Konrad-Blenkle-Straße. Rüsselsheim, Hufelandstraße.
Moin. Moin.
Straße. Friedrichshain. Straße, Otto-Braun-Straße.
Ja.
Mollstraße, Prenzlauer Allee.
Thank you.
Straße Marienkirche.
Moin.
Hey, what's up, Crack? How you doing? It's in early access right now, so think they're in like phase two right now. So they're working on phase three of it. Which phase three, you will see AI buses and actual trains. Yeah, watch out for stuff like that. Okay, that's not bad. Yeah, I was supposed to have been off yesterday, but I didn't pick it up my Tuesday. I normally have Tuesday and Wednesday off. I've been normally picking up Tuesdays lately for some overtime. I'm trying to get my car fixed. I did take my car to the shop today, but I have a friend that's helping me pay for it, so I gotta get some overtime to pay him back. So, I needed a harmonic balancer for my car. I thought that the alternator went out, and then when I took it to Midas, they didn't even have to take out the alternator and realize that it was balanced. So the alternator is not working.
Hi.
And so I got it inside now. They're gonna confirm that it's a balancer, and then I guess they're gonna go from there. The bus is on Steam. That's what I'm playing it on right now. Through this light. I didn't see that. I'm not good at third person driving, especially with this bus. Yeah, I got a Mini Cooper, and I just got the car. I've made like 4 payments on here, so I had the car for like at least like 4 months. And I was telling my friend that when I was helping pay for it, I told him I was driving around the house, and I got ready to turn right, and I heard a pop. As soon as I heard that pop, maybe a few minutes later, I started smelling rubbish. And I was able to get the car back home and everything. But then that's when I realized that something was seriously wrong, you know? Because then my battery quit charging. And then that's when I, like I said, I took it to Midas and I found out, well, I thought it was alternator. And then they told me it was balanced. No, they don't have the MCIs. They just have Scanias. I think they have a eCitaro bus and big Man Lions. Thank you.
eBay trying to find an updated version of that bus for American Truck Simulator. And, the guy has it updated. Yes, you are absolutely right. It is under the BMW brand. And I did my research before I got the car, because originally I was going to get a Jeep. I was going to get like a Jeep Patriot or something. And well, they ended up selling the Patriot before I could even get there. So then they had the Mini Cooper, and I was automatically against it because it's a BMW made car. So I already knew that things were going to be expensive, you know, when it comes to repairs. But I said screw it, I was going to get it anyway. And then yeah, the balance was going to cost me almost $1,400 to fix. And then over time I'm going to need a battery, because of the fact that I let this battery die all the way down. I just been recharging it, you know, if I want to go places. That's like $350 for the battery. And then who knows? Hey, somebody install it, probably will be another $100. So.
Muy bien.
Oh, trust and believe, I tell you what, the dealer told me that as long as I make like 12 payments, that I could trade the car. And that's exactly my plan. I made 8 more payments, and then I'm trading the car. I'm going to do 8 more payments come October. I'm going to see if I can trade the car and get a different one. Because I like this car, don't get me wrong. It's great on gas, but it's very, very high maintenance. Like, even for the balancer alone, it's like $500. And like I said, the battery alone is like $350. Yeah, the DBMX MCI. I looked on the website like a few days ago, and it's not updated for 1.46.
Hauptbahnhof. Moin.
Moin.
Straße, Invalidenstraße.
Curve. VIP member of the website. No. I don't think I am. Are you?
Moin.
Hallo.
Hallo.
Wait, so you do have the MCI for 1.46? Like I said, I'm off today, so I'm going to stream this and then hop on probably a little bit later, stream American Truck Simulator. I was going to download LSPDFR, but the guy I was going to have downloaded, he charges like $100 to do it, and I was going to have him do it. Then I had to get the car fixed, so I had to put that off possibly. I was gonna try to download it myself, but I've downloaded it myself in the past, but just swap in and out.
Hello.
It takes a little bit. And me, I don't know how to correct it if I mess up. So I seriously thought about just spending some time just doing it myself, because one thing that's different now versus back then is that back then I was interested in swapping out different police departments. You know, so I would always be changing out mods and stuff. This time I really don't care. I just want to look at the skin. You know, a couple good looking items, and good go. I thought about just doing that myself. So I'm kind of thinking about it. That takes a while too to install it, going back and forth, then going into the game to see if it works, and then out of the game, download something new, go back into the game. I time, had the patience for it, and then now I don't. So I was just honestly gonna pay him $100 and have him do everything. So he do it, he do everything one time. I never had to worry about switching out anything. I had, and that's it. I gotta worry about switching out things all the time. I had everything I wanted. Yeah, Adriana. Yeah. I talk to her almost every day on Facebook. Yeah, I talk to her about every day, at least every other day.
Hi.
Yeah, I'm gonna have to look into that bus. It's still working. I definitely wanna look more into it. I wonder if you could like have a passenger pick up passengers with that bus. I'm a little early. Near the end right now. Yeah. But the thing is, she works just as much as I do. And I don't know if she's going to be willing to do that. She just doesn't have the time on her hands. I'll wait here for a second. So I thought about just doing it on my own, like I mean I would have to watch tutorial videos and everything, but that just takes a lot of time. Like I said, to go in, because after every mod you install, you gotta go in the game to make sure it works. If it don't, you gotta take it out. And if it does work, you gotta exit out the game, download the next mod, go back in the game, make sure that one works. And the other one still works. You go back out the game, back in, out. I don't have that to do. At least I know this guy, he knows what he's doing. I've heard of him before. I was talking to him a year or two ago about doing the same thing. People really do vouch for him, so I know he's good about what he does, and he could do it quicker than I can, you know. So I said I'm gonna just have him do it. I mean, he charges, and I honestly don't really want to pay the $100, to be honest with you, but I really do want to play the game again, so.
U-Bahnhof Turmstraße.
I think I'm just going there to pay. So I'm going to do the turnaround for this one at least before I end the stream, because I wonder what this turnaround is, because I'm not in a terminal like I was at the other one. So let's see what this turnaround is. That's ridiculous. Let's wait here. I think I might just have to wait here. Oh, hey, no, it's not that far. just turn around. I'll show me where I gotta park at. It's right over here. Like, as in the next phase, like I said, they're going to add AI buses. And when they do that, then I'll be more willing to do more than one round trip. But as of now, you're the only bus that you're going to be able to see. So, I'm like, I feel there ain't no sense in me doing more than one round trip. Never ever got off this bus just to check it. And they really did leave like a lot of track. Man, like a cigarette pack, like water, paper. Transmissions are expensive for Hondas. I never really thought about getting a Honda. Toyota, definitely. Never really thought about getting a Honda. I don't know if the wheelchair got on or the seat just naturally was like that. First time I've done this with this bus. You can press the bus stop button, which I don't think really works on here. It's not gonna work right now anyway, I don't think, until I get to the first stop. That's the one thing I wish they would fix, is the ability to have these cars go around. They're going to otherwise just be stuck here. Oh, they're not waiting for me. I thought they were waiting. They're just waiting for 10. I just got traffic choked up so high that traffic is going to build up until these cars go. I thought about Honda. Yeah, I think they're really cheap cars, but I don't know. I just went ahead with the purchase. Never really truly thought about it. Top of my list is usually like Toyotas, Fords, Lincolns. I think that's all I've ever had. Well, I've never had a Toyota, but let's see, I've had, my very first car was a Pontiac Grand Am. That was like a 95. That was probably the best car I had, like all around. It ran smooth and everything. It was only like a $400 car at the time. Took that car from Ohio to California like about 2 or 3 times. Still ran all the way up until I sold it. I've had 2-3 Lincolns. I had 1 Mercury, Grand Marquis. I had 1 Dodge for the little Dodge movie. I had an old Chevy Blazer. Old, early 90s old. Got a Ford Explorer. That was probably the best A to B car. And that's all that really was. It was really just A to B, and it was perfect for that. But nothing more. Had a Chevy Equinox recently. The engine went out on that, and that was kind of my fault. I was being very neglectful on the oil changes. I was very lazy with getting them done. On top of that, I was doing Lyft, Uber, and other rideshare services, and not getting oil changes. So that kind of caught up to me. So I had to get rid of that car because it wasn't worth replacing the engine at like $3,000 or $4,000. So I got rid of that. I had a Mercury Sabre. That car had potential. I just wasn't willing to fix it. So I had a Sabre. And then right now I have a Mini Cooper. Oh, I had a Ford. It wasn't a Ford. It was a Dodge Caravan. I had that. That was a really good car. The problem with that was I drove it from Ohio to Florida because it was my ex-wife at the time. Her dad had passed. We drove down to Florida for the funeral, and the van made it fine. We ended up getting some bad gas from somewhere. So we was able to filter that out, and it was good coming back. And we drove all the way back, no problem. But then the very next day, when I went out to do, again, Uber and Lyft with the van, my belt popped. The serpentine belt popped out. And able to get it towed back to the house, and I at the same time my payment was due on the van, and I tried calling them. I told them, I said, I could get this belt fixed, but I need like 2 days to work the Lyft and the Uber, and I can come up with the money for the parking lot. 2 days. They have a little thing on there where they can shut the car off when you don't pay. They claimed they didn't have no control over it, so they had shut the car off, so I couldn't make any money. So I told them, I said, well, you might just come get this thing, because we're going to shut it off. That's my only way of making any money. So I tried my best to find that little thing, that little machine. I was going to take it out. I wanted to lie to you. I was going to snatch it out. And I know it's illegal and it probably got me in real trouble, but I mean, I was frustrated at that time. And that van, it was a good, reliable van with just the belt on it. But now with the Mini Cooper, it's the newest car I've had. But it was the quickest to break down out of all the cars I've had. And I see now it's very expensive to fix. And like I was saying earlier, because the alternator quit working and the battery drained all the way down, eventually I'm going to have to replace the battery, because now some of the life is gone from the battery because of that. I was looking that up. The cheapest battery I see for that car was like $300. And likely AutoZone is not going to be able to put that in on the spot. So I'm likely going to have to buy it and pay somebody to do it. So then that's probably going to run me probably another $100 because of where it's located. And, yeah. Like you said, new cars are expensive. And I know that now. So like I said, 8 more payments, I'm taking that car back. And I'm trading it in. I don't want to trade it in because by then I would already be like, I figured I would already be a year into making my payments. So I would have already invested quite a bit of money into the car already. At least a year worth of payments. Just to trade it in and have to redo it all over again. So I don't know. You know what? Back in the day, I used to go to Walmart for all the things like oil changes, tire rotation, battery swap outs, or what have you, but I haven't heard any horror stories per se with Walmart. I just now that I'm getting older, I prefer to pay for premium services, you know what I'm saying? Like, to me, Walmart was a cheap way out. If I didn't have extra money, I wanted to get a $40 oil change, I knew that's where I could go and they could give it to me. And then they'll give me a tire rotation. Almost do everything that an oil change shop can do now at $100. So whenever I wanted anything done cheap, that's where I went to when I was younger. But now that I'm older, I have a decent job, I make decent money, I want premium services, you know. So I don't mind taking my car to Valvoline and paying $110 for a little change. I feel safer. You know, I'm already paying $40. I definitely feel safer going somewhere else and not paying cheap at Walmart for a battery for this kind of car. But if anything, this whole experience taught me to really start putting money aside for car maintenance. Like, I never did that. Out of all the cars I've had dozens of cars. I can't say there's one car where I say, even when I had cars where I was working for Lyft or Uber, I can't say I had one car where I put money to the side of the check just for maintenance. And then I end myself up in these situations that a car do break down, I have the money to fix it. And it's just sitting there. And eventually, if it's not being repoed, I end up selling it because I don't have the money to fix it. But right now, I'm so grateful to have this friend that I have, which is a coworker of mine. So grateful for him to be around, because like I said, we trained together. We went to training the same day together. We ended up becoming like best friends. You know, we hang out outside of work and stuff like that. And forever grateful for this dude, because I didn't even ask him for the money. I didn't ask him for my car to be fixed. All I told him was that I told him I was going to buy another car. And this is how this all came about. Originally, I was just going to work overtime. I had saved a little bit off of this check. Like a couple hundred bucks. And I was going to add that to the next check and just keep adding it, adding it, adding it, until I had enough money to buy another car. In the meantime, I was going to let them just pick up this big Cooper, and I just deal with the repo. And so I knew, like, working all the overtime, the holidays and stuff, I knew I was going to be able to save a chunk of change. And then the taxes coming up, and then the fact that I get my last bonus from this job is like $1,000. I get that last bonus. I hit the next one. So I knew between all that, I knew at the most I was going to have to wait a month and a half. I was going to have another car. So I told him that. I told my friend that. I said, you know, I'm going to just buy another car and everything. And then that's when he was like, well, you already have a car. And I said, yeah, but I said to get it fixed. I don't know if I'm going to do that. It's going to be hard for me to save the money to fix it. And still make payments on it. I'm still making payments. My payment's like $480 a month. I'm paying $180 insurance. So that's like $650 right there between the two. So I said it's hard for me to do all that and save to make the payments. So originally we were just going to buy the part. Then he was going to put it on. But of course, he didn't have all of his tools because he left them back at home in Virginia. So I was going to buy the tool set and everything. And he was just going to put it on and not charge me. But then he recommended it to the shop that he goes to. And, you know, once they gave me the quote and everything, he was like, the quote was like $1,400. I was like, man, that's going to be a while for that kind of money. You know, and then that's when my friend was like, I'll tell you what, they could just loan me, you know, a grand. I was like, I had to think about it, because that's a lot of money to be borrowing from somebody, one. And two, money could mess up a lot of relationships, you know, a lot of friendships. And I'm like, oh, let me think on it, you know, whatever. And he was like, you know, I trust you. I'm going to the same place. I'm going to stay. Pay me back if you can, there you go, or whatever. Eventually, I was like, all right, cool, I'm going to go ahead and do it. And I was like, I'm probably going to need a little bit more. I'm not going to lie to you, because at this time, I still haven't paid my phone bill. I've been holding off on groceries and food for myself, because I wanted to have some type of money. So in case you can't do the $1,200, I would be able to find some way to pay the car off, you know, good. So he was willing to do that. So like I said, I'm like grateful. I really am that, you know, I'm really seriously grateful that he's gonna get back to me. It would have been a minute before I got that car. Simple as that.
Bahnhof Turmstraße.
I'm going to leave some old
kleiner Tiergarten.
Hi.
Moin.
Moin.
Hi.
Straße. Altmoabit, Rathenower Straße.
Moin.
Thank you.
Next time, folks, take care, and thank you for watching.